This coming Thursday, I believe, marks 40 days after the resurrection of our Lord. In other words, the ascension of our Lord takes place this coming Thursday. However, just to make it possible for everyone to attend Mass for the ascension, they moved it to the Sunday. But those of you who come to daily Mass, it's good to kind of be mindful of that. And so the novena, if you are intending to do a novena to the Holy Spirit, will begin on Friday, the day after the Ascension. So even though we celebrate it on the Sunday, it really should take place on the Thursday. And what's also noteworthy is that the readings, even yesterday, the Sunday reading, and the readings for the next few days, all leading up to Pentecost, they are all talking about, our Lord is speaking about sending the Advocate, sending the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth, to reveal all things to you. So the readings will focus more on the Holy Spirit. It's a good reminder to us to have a greater devotion to the Holy Spirit. Now notice how our Lord points out in today's Gospel reading, he's telling his disciples that they are to testify to the truth because they have been with our Lord from the very beginning. So not just the truth of his resurrection. Our Lord actually spoke these words at the Last Supper. So this is part of his Last Supper discourse. But anyways, you know, he wants them to witness to his resurrection and all the truths that he has revealed. And then notice how he goes on to say that, you know, those who kill you will think that they're offering worship to God. And when we think of St. Paul and his ardent persecution of the Christians, he believed that he was doing the right thing. He believed that he was serving God by persecuting the Christians, rounding them up, having them thrown in prison, some of them being killed. Now imagine if you're one of the disciples of our Lord and you're listening to this. Our Lord is saying, well, people are going to come and kill you, and they're going to think that they're doing it for God. And it's not just, you know, from Judaism like St. Paul and the severe persecution. We can think of other religions. So in certain areas in the world, certain religions, as we know, they suppress Christianity. Sometimes they even kill Christians. And that's happening even today. And of course, persecution will come even from secular sources, from atheists, because they don't like Christianity, because we're not politically correct. So this is a reality that we all have to acknowledge, that persecution could come for me. What if I was confronted and asked, are you a Christian? And if I say no, well, I forfeit my salvation possibly, but if I say yes, not only are there severe consequences, but maybe even death. Would we persevere in our faith if confronted with such a situation? And it's actually good for us to try to meditate on that so that we will persevere. And notice how our Lord says, I have said these things to you to keep you from stumbling. Don't stumble in the faith. Be firm in your faith. And you know, when somebody stumbles, it's not as if they're totally prevented from accomplishing their goal. They're just hindered. They're slowed down. If they're in a race, they may not win the race. That's true. But the reality is that all of us stumble when we sin. We stumble. But in the same way that the apostles, the disciples of our Lord, they had a specific mission to which our Lord was calling them, God is calling each one of us to a specific mission also, to attain to heaven, to be holy, to persevere in our faith. Holy Mother Church encourages us to pray for final perseverance because there's no guarantee that we will persevere. Whether it's because of sickness or illness, we start doubting God's love for us, or because of persecution, we may just kind of go with the flow and abandon our faith. There's no guarantee we will persevere. So we need to pray for final perseverance. So this is number one, but you know, each one of us, we have certain roles to play. So as a priest, you know, am I fulfilling my duties as a priest perfectly, totally? I'm sure I'm not. I'm sure I fall short. So in other words, where do I stumble? What are the things in my life that kind of keep me from being the kind of priest that I should be? I should think about these things. I should address these. I should remove these stumbling blocks from my life. And the same can be said of a family person, you know, a husband, a father, a wife, a mother, you know. What is keeping you from being a good mother, a good wife, or whatever? And, you know, whatever job you have in the world, you know, what's keeping you from doing the best that you can in your job, right? So what's keeping you from that? So these are things that we ought to reflect for ourselves also, so that we follow God's will for us to the best of our abilities in every aspect of our lives. This is the ideal for all of us, and first and foremost for everyone, no matter what vocation you have, no matter what job you have, the call to holiness. That's something universal, reiterated by the Second Vatican Council, that the universal call to holiness. We're all called to be holy, and I'm sure we all fall short. So something we need to strive for. What are the stumbling blocks? Let us remove those stumbling blocks. If we do, we become happier even here and now. And our eternal destiny is ever more fully guaranteed. Not only that, but a higher degree of glory in heaven, something that we should really aspire to, something that really should appeal to us.